Good day, students, and welcome to your fluids lab. This lab is the drag force and drag coefficient on a rough sphere. In this video, we'll have a look at your lab guide or the lab report. We'll go through all the equipment we're going to be using, and then we'll go through the method of how the data is captured. And then finally, you'll receive the data to complete your lab. We'll also have a questionnaire that you'll have to finish on Blackboard. Oh, so in the next video, let's go through your lab guide or lab report. All right, so here's your lab guide or your lab report. That's just the front page. On the second page, you have a bunch of instructions. Please have a read through that. The next page, there is the aim of the experiment, the apparatus, the methodology we'll be using, and you also have a couple of pictures showing the equipment we use, and I will go through all of that further down this video. Then step one, please read through that, what needs to be done. Then step two, this is the raw data. There we have a column for the speed controller, the air velocity, the strain, the low and the high, strain deviation and temperature. That's the raw data, and we'll go through that as well. And there will be some graphs you need to plot. And this table's over here, this is your results tabulated. And then you also need to compare your answers to the published data, which is on this page. All right, so the next video, session will be the equipment in the lab that we're gonna use. Let's have a look at the equipment we'll use. So obviously that is the wind tunnel. This is the inlet side of the wind tunnel, and then the air is concentrated through the test section over there. And then here is the exit of the wind tunnel. And we have two fans here at the back, which sucks the air through the wind tunnel, which makes this an induction wind tunnel. The fans is controlled by a VSD, variable speed drive, so we can set the hertz of the motors, drawing different air velocities through the wind tunnel. Inside our test section, we obviously have our ball that we want to test the drag and drag coefficient on. And on this ball, there is little beads glued on. The size of this beads is in the lab guide, which will enable you to calculate the relative roughness, which you'll need for this lab as well. Right, so this ball is connected to a sting. Just note that that sting is exposed to the free stream air velocity, and then underneath this cover, on the shaft, there's a strain gauge. And the strain gauge is connected to our strain indicator over here. This is our strain indicator, so that's one of the raw data points we'll be collecting. Also, inside our test section, we have a pitot tube, which will measure our free stream air velocity, and that is connected to a digital anemometer. We will also be measuring the temperature inside the wind tunnel. And obviously before we do any testing, we have to close it up. In the next session, we'll look at the methodology, how we capture the data, the steps involved to do that. Okay, so now I've closed the wind tunnel. I have zeroed my velocity, so the velocity will be measured in meters per second, and the temperature, well, outside the wind tunnel is 23.9, will be the same air as being sucked through the wind tunnel. And then the strain gauge indicator, I tried to set as close to zero. It's a bit jumpy, and we'll take the low and high readings as we go through the measurements. So we're going to start up our wind tunnel.
Here you can hear it starting up. And over here is the controller. So at the moment, our hertz is at 5. That's our minimum. And we can see our air velocity. Just wait for a bit to get stable. It's about 3.72. And our strain on our ball. So for here we want the minimum and the maximum value we see. So minimum 0. Maximum 16. So that will be our first data point. 3.72 meter per second air velocity and a minimum of 0 strain and a maximum of 14. Then we'll go to our next data point. So we're going to jump in increments of 5. So we'll just adjust it. To 10 hertz. Then we're going to wait for our air velocity to settle. We're going to record that, and then again we're going to record the minimum and maximum values for the strain gauge. So 32 and a minimum of 36 and a minimum of 17. Then we'll go to our next data point. So we're going to jump another increment of 5 to 15. Now you can hear the wind tunnels start making a noise. All the raw data to complete this lab will be provided to you, but it's very important to read through your lab guide that will tell you how to use the data. There is some calibration that needs to be done and a couple of calculations. You also have to plot graphs that will enable you to compare your experimental data with published data. Thank you.